Tonight on the show, the whole gang is here along with the star of Avatar, Sam Worthington, and Rocker's Powderfinger.
Wonderful time to be here. Welcome to our special barbecue edition of Rove. Both the person and the show, I have been pricked prior to the show so I don't burst. We have got something for everyone tonight, all you barbecue lovers. Any beer lovers in the house? Yeah! Right, we do have booze for the beer drinkers. Meat lovers?
Yeah!
For the meat lovers, we've got sausages, and vegetarians. Yeah! Yeah, for the vegetarians, we've got a big bag of oh, boo-hoo. And checking our setup, we've got our barbecue going over here. We've got like any good party, any good barbecue. We've got the customary bath, full of ice and beers. Although to be honest, I've never really understood why we put beers in the bath. You know, like you have people come over and go, okay, everyone, just pop your drinks in the place where I regularly wash my balls. Just the balls. I just go in there overnight and just dip. Rest of me. Still filthy, but that's enough. And we've got our Barbies being fired up as we speak. You'll notice we've got the much simpler barbecues, more traditional. Because, you know, barbecues nowadays have become these giant space-age monstrosities that like are more complicated than the Large Hadron Collider. And it's like, oh, yeah, can I grab an extra sausage? No worries. Psh, psh, psh. Do-do-do-do-do-do-sh. Oh, shit, I'll send it back into the future. I'm sorry, we'll have to... But I know barbecues are such a great way to eat. I mean, you can slap the food on a paper plate, get a plastic knife and that wouldn't cut through soup, let alone a piece of cow, and you end up trying to balance the food on your knees thinking, wow, this is like eating on a plane. Only shitter. All right, let's fire this baby up. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much for watching at home for this. Because not only is it our last show for the year, but it is our last show forever. I've decided myself, after 10 years of doing the show, that tonight will be my last one. And that... Yes, I know. I'm sorry. And... yeah, look, it's one of those things. I haven't. This is purely my decision. It's not one I have made lightly or flippantly or easily, I must say. And but I just think the timing is right. I need to stop, take a step back, and see what happens next. So it's been something that's sort of been sitting on my mind for a little bit. And I think the timing is right now. After 10 wonderful years, I think we're at the perfect spot to be able to stop and do it on our terms while we're still on a high and right off into the sunset, hopefully. So, with that, I say, you know, I know we've made jokes about this on the show before, where I've just gone, oh, I'm leaving. It was like, oh, I'm going to come back after the break. This is not this time. So, if you need to text somebody, if you need to get on the phone, if you need to email, if you need to tweet, if you need to, I don't even know if people phone anybody anymore, but if you want to send off a carrier pigeon and let people know, anyone who might otherwise be watching tonight but isn't, and let them know, I would love for them to be on board to say goodbye before we finish up at the end of it. And, yeah, so I do know it's It does. It is very short notice. I do realise that, but it's only a decision that I came up with very recently. And to be honest, I didn't want a whole lot of fuss going into tonight, as I don't going out the other end as well. And so yeah, I'm sorry that it just sort of seems to be. Is there something going on? Now is not the time for awkward laughter. But, yeah, look, but I also think tonight's the perfect night for it, and we've got the best setting possible. All our cast is here tonight to help wrap this baby up. You guys are, as well as I hope you guys are at home. Will you help send me off in style tonight? Yeah! Okay. Good! Glad you got tickets now, don't you? People are going, oh, one for next week. Ah, shit. So sit back, enjoy, crack open your favourite beverage. I've got vodka in here. And let's get cooking with our first guest.
Sam Worthington was a brickie, but turned to acting and has since built a career in Hollywood. He made his film debut in Bootman, put a modern twist on Shakespeare, and gave an award-winning performance in Somersault before stealing scenes in Terminator Salvation. Now, after being hand-picked for the starring role in James Cameron's 3D epic adventure blockbuster, he experiences life as an avatar.
You are not in Kansas anymore. You are on Pandora. We have an indigenous population called the Na'vi.
The concept is to drive these remotely controlled bodies called avatars. Outstanding. Strong prey on the weak, and nobody does a thing.
They've sent us a message that they can take whatever they want. But we will send them a message. That this is our land!
And this is our Sam Worthington!
So I just wanted to say, if you know, I feel a bit underdressed because of what you just said, and I do know that a lot of people got a tear out because of it, because they've grown up watching you, like myself. But I thought that I'd exactly dress for your damn barbecue.
Sounds perfect to me. And I realised during the little intro piece there, it was the coming out the other end line that was what people were sniggering at. Well, you brought presents as well?
Yeah, I brought presents, mate. Here you go. So, well, I've got my jersey in case I get, like, cold. But I thought, my mate goes, he goes, you can't go to a mate's barbecue and be a mooch.
Yes, good.
So I bought some Snaggers.
Hey, good boy!
Straight up. I also bought you, you got to be a present. I bought you I don't know if you're cooking or not, but he bought you an apron.
Nice.
If you look,
it's like a James Bond apron.
It's licensed the grill.
And I thought you couldn't top plastic boobs, but there you go.
So I tried, trust me, mate, I lost. And the other thing is, you're a Perth boy like myself. You know, you don't go to a good barbecue, you got your beer, but you need a box of wine.
Oh, did I it's not piss fart around.
That's it. The best thing I love about these is, like, I grew up probably like you. I grew up probably like Ro, probably like a lot of yous, that when you've had a bit too much of this, you bring the silver lady out to dance and you blow her up and use her as a pillow. So,
it's a perfect end of night.
After what you just said then, let's get on it, mate. I'm telling you
right
now.
Sounds good to me.
You know, screw the water, put me on it.
How do you crack it?
All I did was spill it all over the desk.
I know yours was vodka, so that's ridiculous. It's a shame.
Oh, there we go.
There we go. Here we go, mate.
Oh, it's good Margaret River stuff, too.
There we go.
So, now, Avatar, I saw... Oh, cheers to you, my friend.
There we go.
Cheers indeed. Hey, everybody. Oh, yeah! Okay, so you've got a couple of huge films on their way, and Avatar's the one that we're about to see.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I caught a half an hour of it the other day, and it is absolutely amazing. Now, it's using, as we saw there, all this sort of computer-generated technology. How much of you... It's actually in this movie.
It's 50-50. The movie's basically, like, okay, for those who don't know, it's the movie's by James Cameron. Now, Jim did Terminator, Aliens, Titanic, for goodness sake. So it's took him about 10 years or 12 years to make another film. And he's come out guns blaring. What he said to me when I first met him was he wanted to bring people back to the cinema. This is a 3D epic like no one's ever seen before. How you shoot it is, as you saw, what I look like is big and blue with a tail. He said on a planet that is computer generated, but when you put your 3D glasses on, you're going to get lost in this planet. And that's the way we shoot it. It took me 14 months to shoot it. It took Jim 5 years to make it.
And you were hand-picked for this role, weren't you?
Yeah, the guy's an idiot. I don't know what he was thinking.
So when you get called to go in for the audition, did you believe that you'd be here at the other end?
Well, I'll be straight up. At the time, I was going through a bit of a crisis. I was about to turn 30. This is like a couple of years back.
Yeah, washed up.
I was washed up. I was thinking, no one's going to hire this dude. And I literally, I sold everything I owned. I had an auction at my house with my mates. And I'm dead set true, and I sold everything and kind of went and thought, I'll go live in my car. And then, and just kind of, you know, like what you're about to do yourself, try and figure out. the more you're just trying to figure out where you fit into the world, where you fit into your life. And, you know, at the time, you know, I get a phone call going, can you do this audition? Did an audition in Australia. Didn't know who the director was, what the project was, anything like that. I then, you know, did what I did, and about a week later I get a phone call going, look, Jim Cameron wants to fly you to America. I said, what for? I said, that was the movie. I go over and meet him, and I said to him, look, I'm living in my car, mate. I've got nothing to lose, so it means I've got everything to gain, which means I'm going to give you damn everything. And for 6 months, I went to work with that man to convince the studio to risk X amount of dollars on a guy from Australia. And I think the good thing about Jim is, you know, he's a lot like Australians in the sense of, you know, you put it all on black, you take that risk on an unknown guy, and you go to work. And, you know, I got lucky enough that we managed to convince the studio to take that risk.
And when you shoot a film like this, I assume it's a lot of running around on an empty set.
It's two things. You shoot it live action, like you saw me when I was live, yeah? Now, the other part, when you're blue, there's a place called the volume. The volume is about an area about as big as this, which is, it's completely grey, there's nothing on it. There's 190 infrared cameras, and you wear a Velcro wetsuit with silver balls on it, and you wear a helmet, and you've got green dots all over your face, so you look like ridiculous, like you're in Cirque du Soleil or something like that. And you basically...
Yes, you heard that, Cirque du Soleil. You look ridiculous.
And when that's the thing, so with a scene like, okay, you see the birds flying, and you see us jumping the birds, so they build like a rig, like something like this, yeah? So something like this will be, they put dots on this, and this will be like the bird.
Yep.
And then what you'd basically do is you ride the fucking bird like this. And that's what you'd get, all right? Excuse my language. But you know,
what are they going to do?
What are they going to do?
Now, also, I mean, you've got Avatar, Clash of the Titans is coming up. Like, we just saw you in the recently in the Terminator movie.
Yeah.
This was the one where Christian Bale did a spacker on
set, which he went off like a pork chop.
He did his nut on set. Were you there when it happened?
I wasn't there. That was round two.
Was it really?
Yeah, and round one got out because of your body mics that you got on. So I've got to watch myself tonight, and I just proved that screwed, didn't it? But the thing is, you know, I remember I said to Christian, you know, I sent him an email saying, mate, you know, you're famous, because they made a remix of him.
It was a dance mix?
Yeah,
it was all over YouTube.
They put him on Family Guy. You know, oh, I loved it. So I said, you're famous, good on you. And he wrote back the whole rant to me, dead set, the whole rant going, you're a nice guy, but you're unprofessional, you know, screw you, do all this. So you can see he realised he went off. And, you know, he apologised on some radio show. And, you know, and the thing is with Christian, in his defence, he's a quiet guy. And wears track pants to work and... Normal, most quietest man, all right? And I asked him once, he said, this is dead set, he said, when he was doing Batman, he said, the cowl gets real hot and the cape gets really heavy. And he said he wanted to take him off, but he didn't want young kids to see him, you know, without the cowl.
Absolutely.
To lose the illusion. So they put him in like a little tent. So there's this guy, he's sitting in a tent, and he wondered for about half a day why no one's coming to talk to him. Because everyone in the outside is going, well, Christian's preparing. You know, you don't want to go near him. He's, you know, be careful. He's too crazy. You know, he is intense, all right? And that was the thing. And when you meet him, he's, You know, he'd be paddling in that pool now, drinking about half of that, having a good time.
Well, the show's not over yet, so you're more than welcome to be a Christian Bale worthy.
He is. He's a nice guy, mate.
Well, are you ready, Sam Worthington, for your public probe? At last, ever, public probe. You ready for this? Annette from Montrose, Victoria, have you used your tap dancing skills since Bootmen?
I didn't even use my tap dancing skills in Bootmen. I did a lot of this, and they cut me out.
That's how Kermit the Frog did it. Tara from Peakhurst, New South Wales, what can you always be relied on to do after a few drinks?
We'll soon find out, won't we?
And Hank from Mackay in Queensland, does James Cameron really threaten actors with knives?
Yes.
Does he really?
Yeah.
Well, that machete, he's got a thing of if a mobile phone goes off on set, he nail guns it to the wall. So you know full well on the exit that you never have your mobile phone go off on set. That's it.
That's Hollywood for you, kids. You can catch Sam and his alien friends when Avatar opens on December 17 across Australia and New Zealand. You
thanks
do not want
me,
to
mate.
Miss this one. Sam that's Worthington. Awesome. Thanks, yeah. Mate. Good to see you. Thanks for coming on. Go! Do what you got to do! We'll be right back!
Still to come on the season finale of Rogue. Hamish and Andy. Pete Space. Judith Lucy. Philosophisationer Ryan Shelton, Powderfinger will perform their latest hit, and the last ever Kevin Rudd PM.
Hi, Andy from Hamish and Andy here. A little exhausted after a fun, long, but fun year of fun row segments. What are you doing?
I'm the ghost of segments past.
You look a little bit more like an angel.
Well, I'm supernatural and I can fly, so be impressed.
Okay, what are you doing here?
I heard you say you couldn't remember a single Rove segment you'd done, Andy.
No, I can remember all the segments.
He doesn't remember them.
Let me take you back.
Do you remember the time that you went to Tasmania on a tall ship?
Yes,
I do. Oh, he doesn't remember. How about the time you invented put pocketing?
Oh, yeah, I do remember.
No, you don't. Oh, come on, how dumb are you? You must remember the time you went to America.
Yes, I remember that. I remember everything. But if you don't at home, you'll get the chance to see it on our very early Christmas special.
Tune in next Monday, the 23rd at 7:30 on Channel 10.
For lots of Christmassy fun.
Well, Ham, we've told everyone about our Christmas special.
What makes you think I'm Ham?
Your face.
It's Peter Hellyer, Christy Warner, Judith Lizzie, Ron Shelton, and Hamish and Andy. So, boys, regifted last year.
Before you go on, Rove, we use the same technology for our graphics as James Cameron did in Avatar.
Yeah. And I've got to, I have to back up what Sam was saying. It's great to work with Jim. He's great. he's a really good guy.
I believe that outfit.
Yeah.
It was amazing. Now, last time it was at your mum's place, Andy.
Yeah, last regifted was at my parents' house. This year we're at Hamish's grandma's house.
You know.
Lucy!
Largely because Hamish stole from my house.
Oh. And,
such relaxed security. You guys should have been there. It was awesome. Really good.
Now, everybody has brought a plate of something to the barbecue, yeah. Which is nice.
Yeah.
Now, Pete, yours looks weird.
Well, people think it's controversial. I don't think it is at all. It's dim sims on a barbecue. If you've not had dim sims on a barbecue, you are missing out.
Have they been cooked?
They're a fraction cold. I obviously cooked 3 days ago.
You're not going to find a good one in there, so you might as well just pick one and
eat one. You try a barbecue dim sim, and I think you'll enjoy it.
Really?
Yeah. Very nice, isn't it?
It's lovely.
It is lovely.
I like Christy's gone old school.
Yeah, well, we knew it was a very special night for you tonight, Rove, so what better way to cap off 10 years than with some Cabanossi and maraschino cherries?
I love it. I
only bring it out for the big occasions.
And Hamish Nandy went porno? What the hell is...
We had a bit of an argument as to whether to go healthy or unhealthy.
Health dogs. it's just a simple sausage inserted with consent in an apple.
Are they just like, they're kind of like
granny snaggles?
Yeah.
Like granny snags.
Yeah, it's just a cool way to combine. Everyone knows if you eat an apple, it undoes any bad food you've eaten.
That's true.
It's a neutral piece of food. Keeps more than the doctor away, I'll tell you what. You eat one of these, you look crazy.
Rude of the host not to try it.
Oh, absolutely. Allow me to.
Make sure you get a bit of both.
Oh, cheeky, come back in.
It's the perfect mix, isn't it? Mm. It's like there's a party in your mouth, but no one's invited because it's a shit party.
Correct. Jude, what have you got?
Look, we went big on fresh ingredients in the household, so it's instant mash. And it's fun because if you eat it straight out of the pack, it's like spud-flavoured dirt. So really, give it a crack.
Oh, one stop now. Yeah, that.
You'd be good to that.
That's all right. It's standing at attention for you.
Okay. I think you're supposed to put that up.
You don't tell me what to do.
I'm so sorry. You're supposed to put that up.
That's boring. Oh, that's...
Here comes the call.
Great.
Masherific. And Rye, what on earth is that?
Porridge, obviously. And there's lots of spoons there, so there are only four spoons, so if you have brought your own spoon tonight, I'd appreciate it if you use that.
Porridge, anyone porridge? No?
No,
Nick,
take
Peter, do you want to
Sam's
put some porridge?
In.
Okay, Nick and I are on the bar.
You're a brave man.
Good, drink, be merry, everyone.
Oh, good. Thanks, Sam.
He loved it,
Not bad, not bad.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the last ever Pink Space! Would be wanting an apple with a sausage in it to get the taste of something else out of my mouth. Well, Peter, how are you doing?
I'm good.
We are after all these years.
I know, and I'm looking forward to living in Sam Worthington's car because he has a better car now because he's Hollywood now. So I look forward to that, Sam. Please welcome James Matthews from the Australian Navy, the Pink Space.
James Matthews. Looks like a bright young kid, big future in the
Massive
Navy.
Future. They do a great job in the Navy, there's no doubt about that, Rove. But now more than ever, Australia needs a Navy to be aware and alert. And while checking out the Australian Navy website this week, I came across James Matthews, a Navy technician, who had some time in his hands to speak about life protecting our ocean borders.
Pay is a lot better, like especially at the start of trying to get your trade and that, in the outside world. Like, it's not, they don't pay you that much. And being in the Navy, they pretty much give you a pretty good pay while learning, and then when you finish learning, you can only get a pay rise. So, I don't think that's good, actually.
I don't think that's good, actually.
You guys were out of that out, weren't you? Now, I've watched a fair bit of Sea Patrol over the years, Rove, so I know that that siren can mean only two things, imminent attack or Lisa McCune has just declared happy hour. We did our own research here at the SS Pete Space, and we can now reveal the full extent of that siren.
And then when you finish learning, you can only get a pay rise. So, I don't think that's good, actually.
Luckily, everybody escaped. Please welcome the just plain weird, sedated guy to Pete Space.
Just plain weird.
Just plain weird.
Just everyday household weird.
On Pete Space, over the years, we have looked at a lot of people who have made, tried to cause a bit of an annoyance and trouble for reporters.
In the background,
waving their hands like this and being against. Yeah. But this guy took annoying to a whole new level.
Um 11 alternativo na formação de João Ferreira, com a chamada inclusivamente de 4 júniores e 1 juvenil, às ordens de João Ferreira. Pedro Rocha e companhia.
Either that guy is the most chilled out dude in the world, or he's on the way home after a massive night with Andre Agassi. I guess, to be honest, when I think about it, Rove, I guess you could have a worse bloke behind you. Mm-hmm. You could have... for the final time. I think I'm going to miss him most.
Yeah.
Nice car.
Someone's doing burnouts in the street. That's great.
For the final Pete Space entry ever, I feel it's only right to welcome David Hasselhoff to Pete Space.
I was worried when I stopped getting amusing photos of him on the email. I assumed something had happened.
No, he's still alive and well. And this week marked the 20th anniversary of the fall of the Berlin Wall. But more than the wall coming down, it also marked the 20th anniversary of David Hasselhoff's most famous gig.
I've been looking for freedom.
If this is the price of freedom, then lock me up now, goddammit!
Well, the Hoff returned to Berlin this week for the European Music Awards, and he was asked if he remembered that famous night 20 years ago.
I've been looking for freedom, I've been looking so long.
We didn't actually ask you to sing, Mr. Hasselhoff.
Years ago, I sang on the Berlin Wall to a million people on the single that was number one at that time called Looking for Freedom. And Looking for Freedom just happened to be number one.
Okay, we get it, Mr. Hasselhoff. You had a number one single in Germany 20 years ago.
I was on a TV show called Night Rider. The theme of Night Rider was One Man Can Make a Difference. But the people behind the wall didn't know me as a TV star. They only knew me as a man who sang about freedom.
Yes, he came back to talk about the fall of the Berlin Wall and Knight Rider. Interesting to get his take on the theme of Knight Rider being about one man can make a difference. I always thought the theme of Knight Rider was that talking cars are cool. But Hoff's night didn't end there. He was there for the European Music Awards and he had an award to present.
I've been looking for freedom.
Oh my God!
These Germans are responsible for the wall coming down. They are responsible for the wall coming down because they believed in freedom! And they never gave up! Hi!
That's not quite right, is it?
Yes, well, you're right. They never gave up, but sometimes giving up can be a good thing. So the Hoffs in Europe were over, okay? It's a glamorous awards show. There's beautiful European women around. He's got fame. He's got fortune. I wonder how his night ended.
This is a mess.
It has been a mess. That was Pete Space. Thank you very much.
The news, hear from Judith Lucy, and catch the premiere of Nick and Haydo's debut single.
Tonight, now we're having our big barbecue party, and obviously at every barbecue there are certain types of people that always turn up. So what we thought we'd do was find out who's who at a barbecue. First up, there's the freeloader. That's the bloke who always turns up with bugger all and somehow manages to consume more than anybody else.
What's going on?
Hey, mate, how you going? Can I chuck your meat on?
Yeah, no, I didn't bring meat. Bought the party instead. Right. It's not the kind of meat you can put on the barbecue.
No meat there?
No. Although I will need a tap to fill this up, unfortunately.
Sure. Is that legal? Can you even...
Yeah, you can bring an empty bottle to a barbecue.
Go over there. So
I actually skip a bit of that in and say it's liqueur, just for the moment.
Then there's always someone who doesn't eat meat at all.
I'm going to need you to cook my not-sausage, but not near the meat. Can we build another barbecue or something?
Right.
I will jump in on one of those.
Oh,
sure,
yeah.
Put mine anywhere. Right. With that.
And no barbecue is complete without a dodgy uncle, the kind who kisses you hello with his tongue.
Hey, mate.
Petey.
Your girlfriend's hot?
Yes.
She single?
No.
How old do you love?
21.
A bit old, What about you, stud? Any grass on the wicket?
Then there's the alcoholic chain-smoking aunt whose idea of a balanced meal is a glass of wine and a cigarette.
You're a good lad. I'll give you 50 cents now, you give me a kidney in 10 years.
The most annoying bastard at any barbecue is the barbecue Nazi.
Oh, mate, don't cook chops like that. You'll bloody ruin them.
The sausages.
Good point. turn them.
Sorry,
turn them.
Yes,
turn not that much. You'll ruin them. Do you know what you're doing?
No!
Well, this party's ruined. Sorry, everyone.
Hey. No sauce on my sausages. I want gin and tonic.
Right.
Just gin.
Now, there's the... There's also the guy who always makes his own homemade dips.
Look, everyone.
Hey,
it's Tzatziki.
I don't know who he is. Then, of course, the neighbour. There's always the neighbour you felt obligated to invite.
Hi. Yeah, great place. Really good place. I love my place. We're just on this side of the fence. In fact, we should get a gate so I can just come straight through all the time.
Maybe, no.
They're nice friends, if I get to meet any of them. Do you want to introduce me to your friends?
You should stand further away.
Okay, yeah, do that right now.
And, of course, my personal favourite is the slightly racist grandmother.
You can tell I'm a grandmother because I've got a clutch purse. Yeah, sorry I'm late. Look, I had to call 7 cabs before I could find one with an Australian driver.
Look, everyone, Tabbouleh.
Tabbouleh? More like Tabbouleh-shit, mate.
Then, of course, there's also the hot young cousin who just doesn't want to be there.
Hey, what are you texting?
That's
a long text message.
Oh, isn't it?
Hey!
Hey, keep walking.
Okay!
I'll walk with you.
No, thanks, mate.
Okay.
And of course, no party would be complete without the partying polar bear! Woo! Now we're talking! Care for some rum, party polar bear?
No, I'm an actual polar bear, so I don't drink. If it makes you happy, I did take a dump in your driveway. All right?
And that's who's doing a barbecue!
Can you keep turning those for me?
That'd be great. I really want
you. Now it's time for Christy at the news desk!
No schedule here. Good evening, I'm Christy Warner, and the last time I turned a sausage was when I picked up a gay guy. Making news this week, Harry Potter star Daniel Radcliffe has been photographed allegedly smoking a marijuana joint. Radcliffe denied using drugs before announcing he had a train to catch and walking into a wall. A Brisbane man has been arrested for photographing up the skirts of 22 unsuspecting females. The accused man says everyone has their knickers in a twist over nothing, and that he has the pictures to prove it. An American man claims that every morning Jesus Christ miraculously appears in the window of his pickup truck, just after Johnny Walker miraculously appears in his coffee cup. The Victorian Institute of Forensic Medicine is conducting tests on a skull claimed to belong to Ned Kelly. The first test will be, does this skull fit in a bucket? And finally, a Google search has reunited a father and daughter after nearly 30 years. He wasn't specifically looking for his daughter. He just typed in hot tit sluts and got an unfortunate surprise. And that's what's making news tonight. Back to you, Rose.
Sadly, only 50.
Really?
What a way to end it, I know.
Hot tit sluts.
Yes.
That's such a desperate time to be just putting all those into the search field. I'm in a hurry, I just need something good. Anything.
It's just not right. Now, I felt bad when I called you to tell you that tonight was going to be it for me. Because you also had that with your radio show this week as well.
Yes, we've had a very tough week with Rosso deciding to leave the American Rosso and Kate Ritchie breakfast team alongside Kate Ritchie as well, deciding to pursue other things, and then you call me and all I have to say is, I'm sorry, Australia, I think I am the kiss of death.
She is, and we wouldn't have it any other way. Christy Warner, everybody. Stick around, there's a lot more fun sizzling away.
Up next, our resident philosophisationer, Ryan Shelton.
Hey, your mum.
Your mum doesn't even make any sense. What a weird thing to say.
Reading Earth by Senator Bob Brown. Here with a big plate of philosophisationing. I'm so glad I don't have to say that anymore. It's Ryan Shelton!
Thank you. Thank you.
Right. Isn't there usually a thing?
There's usually a thing, but
allow
we're not
me.
Doing the thing.
Look, you've got to think and do ponder stuff. We do the lady voice Jess thing?
I don't know the voice.
Philosophizationing with Ryan Shelton.
There we go.
I've done it.
Hey, Ry.
Seamless.
Ry, it has been a very big year for philosophizationing.
Yeah, it has. I feel like I'm really close to just solving life. I feel like I'm really close, really, really close.
I hope so.
One more. One
really?
More. One more. One more. All year, I've been philosophizationing many of life's most difficult questions. Questions like, what's the key to happiness? What's the deal with karma? And is there a God? But I've been saving the most difficult and most important question for tonight. Tonight, I will answer the greatest question of all. Tonight, I will answer, what is the meaning of life? So why are we here? What is our purpose? Because we're all so different, how could there possibly be one universal meaning to our many different lives? I mean, I could ask Socrates here, history's greatest ever philosopher, but I just don't trust a man with a moustache. Sorry, Soc. These regular people over here look far more trustworthy. Excuse me, what do you think the meaning of life is, Karen?
I reckon it's to eat good food.
Okay, and you, Rufus?
Well, I think the meaning of life is to fall in love.
Interesting. Two very diverse opinions. But let's test them out. Karen, shall we? Is Karen right? Is eating good food really the meaning of life? Let's have a taste. Mm-mm. Oh, not if it's overcooked like that. You're wrong, Karen. Jeez, al dente my ass. I can't believe the nerve of
this. Hey, you haven't even paid.
Oh, hang on a second. Sorry, how much is it?
$20.
For overcooked spaghetti? Jeez, there you go. Your spaghetti is not the meaning of life, though.
Yay, your mum.
Your mum? Doesn't even make any sense. What a weird thing to say.
And cue the girl.
Maybe Rufus is right.
Oh, maybe Rufus was right. Maybe falling in love is the meaning of life. Hey, babe. Do you think that we're in love?
Yeah, I think we are in love.
Falling in love is great, but I'm not sure it's the meaning of life. Sorry, Rufus. You're wrong.
Yeah, your mum is wrong.
Your mum's wrong? Again, that makes no sense. What's with the mum stuff? It seems really strange to keep bringing up my...
What about your mum?
Oh, sorry, Koala, I can't quite understand.
Dad, what about your mum?
You're going into retirement? What? Oh, shit, it's not a real koala.
What about the environment?
Oh, the environment, yes. Good point. What about our environment? Maybe our purpose for being here is to simply, I don't know, like, save our planet. Hey, I'm walking here. I'm walking. After all, without somewhere to live, how can we have a life to give meaning to anyway? Let's save some trees. Thank you. Oh, yeah, you're probably right. She was just saying that I should have chosen a tree they were trying to actually cut down. Good point, bird. Well, what? No, sorry, I don't have a lighter. I don't smoke. Oh, my bus! I ran over to catch my bus. The same bus I catch every day. Whoop, mind the extra. I sat in the same seat, right behind the same person with whom I have the same conversation every day. But today was different. Oh, hey, Toby. Hey, you know, I know we always talk about girls and stuff.
Oh, yes, girls.
Yeah, but I was wondering, what do you think the meaning of life is?
Well, Ryan, that's a very hard question.
It is.
I would think it'd be to live every moment like it was your last. Mm-hmm. Because at any moment, it could be.
Everybody freeze! Do as I say and no one gets hurt.
Somebody call Keanu Reeves!
At that moment, with my life in the balance, I was forced to decide what the meaning of my life really was. Was it love? Was it food? Was it the environment? Or was it something more? I got it. That's the meaning of life. I've figured it out. I gotta get out of here. With the meaning of life all figured out, I made my surprisingly easy escape.
Boy, stop or I'll shoot!
Oh, stop or my mum will shoot, which was a good film. I spotted a conveniently placed chopper. I can't believe it took me this long to figure it out. The meaning of life is obvious. It's right there to grab a hold of. It's beautiful. It's grand. It's
couldn't quite hear.
Yeah.
What, you were in the thing.
I
couldn't
know.
Quite hear.
Isn't it amazing? The meaning of life. You're welcome.
Ryan Shelton, everyone.
That was a really, really dumb idea. That was a very dumb idea. All right. I'm glad you touched on that. It was nice.
Yeah.
All right. Please welcome now two members of our Barbie band for this evening, Powderfinger, Bernard Fanning and John Cogill. Now this party can begin.
It's time for some sweets.
Now, you're looking very Movember, I hope.
That's right.
It's not
been
first,
working hard.
Not some other side project that we should be worried about.
it's a bit like the village people or something like that's going on. Which you can join anytime you want, mate.
No, I can't. That's
I mean, the silver tie.
That's the problem. I just can't. There's nothing going on for me. Now, you guys just got back from Thailand.
Yeah.
How was that? How did that go?
It's great. We went and made a video over there at a festival called Ye Peng, which was...
Was it a porno?
Yeah. It was pretty interesting.
They'll pirate it because it's Thailand.
It's a lot of Thailand.
You probably have got a pirated copy before you even made it.
And how are you guys working together now? I mean, we've got the new album Golden Rule, which is fantastic. Do you guys feel you're a bit more synergized as a band? You've got a bit more togetherness than you did before?
Yeah, absolutely.
Should we agree on that answer? Actually, we've been thinking about, I mean, there's all these rumours of us breaking up and everything, but what's really happening is we're going to franchise the band around the world, like the Wiggles, actually.
That would work a treat.
That's the idea.
Yeah. Now, I would love to.
Yeah, well, who would you like to be?
I need a gig! Now, can I go through some of the other possible names that Golden Rule had? Do you remember any of these? Tonight Us, Bring Back Pluto, Too Cool for Tracksuit Wednesday, No Mercy on the Unsuspecting Dancer, Adult Baby, Romancing the Poodle, Slightly Broken, Heavy Metal Cardigan, Raising Squid, and Phil Jamieson from Grinspoon's Jizz Pillow. And you went with Golden Rule in the end?
Yeah.
And the reason for that over the
others? We couldn't get clearance on the last one.
And so how is it going as the band? Are you feeling good? Are you feeling back with this one for sure?
We're really excited, actually. Just came out on Friday, and we're doing some shows in over summer, doing festivals again for the first time in, I don't know, 5 years or something. So, we can't wait. Can't wait to get out there again.
Now, I can see you've got the rest of the boys are playing backyard cricket in front of my sign there, which I'm hoping to keep. So
hopefully Darren is bowling the secret ball to JC, which is, we call it the in-swinger to the nuts.
Is that what you guys do for therapy? Do you do stuff like that to help relax when you're in the studio and working on stuff?
Yeah.
Well, we used to do it a lot more. We used to play tons of cricket, actually.
Yeah. It inspired internationalism. That's all we did, cricket and music, pretty much. Yeah. So they got us through that.
Now, guys, right now we have a little something we'd like to play with you. It's called Mystery Meat. As we are at a barbecue, we have three mystery types of meat that Haydo and Nick have been cooking at the barbecue, and
three of us from the couch have taken a small slice from our buttocks. Right,
so it's not a mystery.
So whoever's sitting,
would like to clear a space here.
It's a really funny story.
So we have three. I don't even know what's what. Oh, okay. All right. So Bernard, do you want to have a pick one and have a guess at what you think it is?
I'll go with the white meat.
The white meat. The white meat.
The safest. That's human.
You got it.
Close, very close. That's actually crocodile.
Ah.
Colt, nice. do you want to try one of the others?
Big game.
No, just.
Wow.
What have we got here?
Oh. That's spam, isn't it?
It is spam! Oh.
Do you guys want to try?
I've just got one last one. I'll just throw it over. And someone can just try it themselves. How'd you get spam? Do you eat spam? Who's
all
eat spam?
The time. Yeah. Ham and pineapple pizza.
I can't remember what this last one is. Oh, yeah, I think I do. All right.
Try this, Jay.
Here we go. Mm. Final mystery meet.
Does it remind you of boarding skill, JC?
Steak.
It's a steak.
Of?
Of.
Beef.
No, it's camel.
Oh.
You totally ate something with a hump. You're filthy. All right, the boys will be back to perform for us later on from the album Golden Roll.
Successful rock acts. Want proof? 2 million albums. 16 arias. 5 number one album debuts. 3 successive arias for album of the year. 2 entries in the Triple J Hottest 100. Not bad, hey? See them perform their latest huge hit, All of the Dreamers, later on Rove.
Very close to having to finish everything up, but actually we've still got a little while to go, so I think it's about time we paid acknowledgement to these boys here, the Rove Daly boys, Nick and Haydo. Yeah. Gentlemen, nice to see you here.
Thank you,
it's been
Rove.
A big year, learning all about the wonders of our website.
Yes, the biggest year of our lives, I would say. Nick?
I think that's an overstatement. Oh. I don't know why you put us in charge of Rove Daily, because we know nothing about the internet. I'd just smash mainframes with a hammer if anything went wrong.
Well, I mean, we do know things about the internet. We know right. MILF Hunters.
Yes.
We know YouPorn.
Yes.
We know BustyBigGirls.com.
I think that's all just porn, mate. But anyway, we're going to take this opportunity to... You should know this, Rove. You probably don't, because you don't pay attention. But we are musicians. We are musicians at heart.
Big time.
Miss that. You what?
Musicians.
Musicians. Musicians.
Yep. Music is our first love, always has been.
Yep. Right.
And that's what we're passionate about. And
rock and roll.
We're moving on, like you. We're moving on, and that's what we've bloody done.
We're blowing this gig.
We've got a clip.
We've put something together.
We've got a clip.
We've been in the studio.
All week.
That's in there, and we've got our first single.
Let's have a look. I can't wait.
No, that is not our sound.
Turn that up. Turn that one up.
Yes! Oh. That's our sound! Suck on that, Veronicas!
That's the shit, Julio! I can feel it in my balls, man!
Woo. Let's make our music clip.
Oh, yeah. MTV, here we come! Woo.
This is the music business. This is why we're in it.
And sign some CDs.
Yes, sir. I am ready. I am ready to do that.
Do you think we got the time right?
Mate, the groupies will be here in minutes. I promise.
Oh, God! Come here, you little shit!
We should end up without two.
It is indeed.
It is a heady world. Now, I wasn't aware of this at the time, but you had a little incident with John Mayer a couple of weeks ago.
I did have a very weird moment with John Mayer off camera, but I've got to be honest with you and say that I've had a number of weird moments with Americans over the years. I actually went out with a boy who was an American. Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm sure he still is an American. I just enjoy talking about him as though he's dead. And he was actually so small and so round, he was virtually a circle. And when we were in restaurants, he would insist on feeding me. So people must have thought I was recovering from a stroke. But Americans can be odd. I met another American recently who was actually on a cycling holiday. Who puts those two words together? Cycling and holiday, you may as well put lawn mowing and sex together. No, my odd moment with John Mayer was his parting words to me off camera were not, "Can I have your number? Jennifer Aniston's a bit of a dog." Right. Was obviously what I was expecting.
As would I.
What he honestly said to me, and Pete and Chrissy can confirm this, he honestly turned to me and he said, "I'd like to see you smile more."
What? Is that true?
That is 100% true.
Yeah. I'd like to see the end of poverty and the assassination of André Rieu. That's not going to happen. I mean, I'd like to see you smile more. I just sat there thinking, you might be incredibly hot and talented, but I'd like to see you get rooted. And I think Pete and Chrissy can also confirm this. What I actually said was, I'm just a very unhappy person. Which is true. I hate life. But that's nobody's business.
I mean, no.
You know, what's it to Who's John he? Mayer whether I smile? I'm not the Mona Lisa. I'm not, you know, a dental work model. I'm not Terry Hatcher after a bong. Gee, you can be careful too. If you're that thin and you're smiling that hard, you'll die. But in John Mayer's defence, I will say I have gotten stuff like that for years. People will literally walk up to me in the street and say, "Smile." Now, I would like to walk up to certain people in the street and say, "Wash." It's not my fault that my relaxed expression looks like someone's just said the condom's burst. I have to live with that.
Well, you've been making me smile all year. I'm so glad we got you on board this show.
6 months.
It did. It did the job.
It just felt like a year.
Jim Lucy, thank you very much.
The final ever jaw-dropping episode of Kevin Rudd PM.
I expect a burnout in about 30 seconds every time we show that shot from the top of the building. Someone just goes, "Burnout!" Now, of course, we couldn't wrap up this show or the year without talking to our Prime Minister, our old pal, Kevin Rudd, PM. Are you there?
Hey, Rove, how great is this Skype? My mate Altit raves about it. And the technology is so advanced now, it's no longer all jump, jump, jumpy.
Well, look, Altit knows his stuff, but I'm not really sure about that.
Anyway, Rove, I'm calling you from another galaxy.
Wow, another galaxy. How did you get there?
It's a long story. Watch this. The world was coming to an end. There was fire, brimstone, and economic crisis. People were depressed and angry. But if there was one thing that could make them happy, it was my lilting, infectious laugh. Ouch! So, I decided I would bring joy to everyone in the world by beaming my laugh into hundreds of worldwide concerts, as well as every radio and TV in every home across the globe. It was gonna be laugh-tastic. Don't worry, world, this'll cheer you up. It turns out my laugh heard around the world just freaked everyone out. They all turned on me, even my good buddy Derek. He and his world authorities had me arrested and sent to prison until they decided what to do with me. It was pretty scary walking into prison, but I figured my genial personality would get me by. And the first thing I did was take a nice, relaxing shower. Uh-oh. Twitter time! And tweeters, you know how they say don't drop the soap? Well, there's a bloody good reason for that. People can be so rude. My big fat cellmate keeps making me paint his toenails. God, it's like being at home with Therese. Hooray! It's finally happened, guys. Barry asked me to be his bitch. Sitting in my cell wondering what would happen to me, I saw my whole life flash before my eyes. I thought back to when I was born in New York City. I was raised by three actors, Tom Selleck, Ted Danson and Steve Guttenberg. Guttenberg was the worst, always gaying things up. Then I thought back to when I was a teenager, and no one believed I could fly.
Rudd, you stupid sod, get down from there.
No, I'm gonna fly to Macca's. Then I thought about the really big moments, like when I became boxing's world champion. Yo, Adrian, go ready. And the time I headed up the mafia.
Don Ruddy, please help me.
So what can I do for you, Uncle Tony? And then when I went to Hollywood and landed the role as the shark in Jaws. I'm a shark, I'm a big shark. But all my reminiscing was suddenly interrupted. Finally, a decision was in from the World Court. They would let me out if I agreed to stop laughing.
Kevin Rudd, will you stop laughing?
No, I won't. That was it. The world decided they had no option but to send me into outer space, never to be heard from again. But it wasn't too bad. It was quite peaceful in outer space. And they gave me a copy of Mr. Deeds starring Adam Sandler. Hilarious. And there was always my onboard computer, Swanny, to talk to. I love that Mr. Deeds.
Hello, Kevin.
Oh, hey, Swanny. I guess it's just you and me for the rest of eternity.
Eternity? Is that a long time?
Yes. Yes, it is, Swanny. And in space, you can definitely hear me laugh.
A story, Mr. Rudd, and now you're in another galaxy?
Yes, and I'll be here for quite a long time. Unless those space monsters come back. No, wait! They're here right now! Rove, help me! Ah! Oh, God, no!
Whoa, oh, my God. Mr. Rudd, are you okay?
No, it's all right. Somehow a magpie got in the cockpit. Kept me good. Probably just protecting its eggs. Anyway, bye, everyone!
Thank you, Mr. Kevin Rudd, PM. And on that, I think a very special round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the man who puts it together each and every week, the voice of Kevin Rudd, Mr. Nick Maxwell. Always gaying it up. All right, well, as always, that wraps up the week, a week in which we filmed our final show in a car park, which is also where I'll be living until I can find another job. But what else have we learned? Well, I've learned that I'm the luckiest guy in the world to have spent the last 10 years with my best friends. Although I do have to change my best friends every few years, depending on what the network wants.
Well, I've learned that I like my steak the same way I like my parking inspectors, rare and bloody.
I learned there are two differences between animals and humans. They don't have opposable thumbs and they can't bleach their anus.
Tonight I've learned that telling everyone that you're pissed in your own beer is a great way to stop people from stealing your beer. Ultimately, they're still going to think that you're drinking your own piss, though.
I learned that my grandparents think that next year will be my year, which is great, but it makes me think, whose year is this year? Yours? I don't think so. You're lazy.
I've learned that being given the opportunity to join the Rove team has been such a positive experience. It's just unfortunate that I had to change my name because all my friends know me as Pitt Hellier.
I've learned that leotards can be quite revealing and it turns out I've got a camel toe and it's got humps, so that's quite... Oh, I wanted to make tonight a special one, so I went out this late week and I learned a great fact. I learned something about women.
Oh, well, before you say it, you should just whisper it to me so I can make sure it's appropriate for everyone.
Okay, sorry, 2 seconds.
No, that doesn't.
Yeah,
that
it
doesn't
does.
Work.
It does.
No.
Yeah, you put smoke in, they'll come running out.
That's bees.
No, it's not bees. You smoke it up, they come running out and you and grab them and they make honey for you.
No, no.
That is bees. Sorry, I learned a fact about bees is what I meant. They have three erogenous zones.
No, that's women.
That is women. Okay. I learned nothing. Sorry.
I've learned that according to Nicole Kidman, her relationship with Keith is, and I quote, incredibly raw and you're very much at sea. Is she married to a singer or a piece of steak with a prawn on it? It's surf and turf.
I've learned there's nothing like a barbecue to make you feel like a man. But sometimes I wish sausages were either a little less delicious or a little less penis-shaped. And you can read all about it in my new book, Check Out My Man Snag.
Yeah, there you go.
We will properly finish up in just a sec after we hear from these boys playing the single All of the Dreamers from their new album Golden Rule. I could not be more happier to have these guys close this entire show for me. Ladies and gentlemen, Powderfinger!
Shadows in the dark, we follow the leader.
It's out now. Go and get it. Thanks also Sam Worthington, everybody, for joining us tonight.
Obviously, it's the last show, and somebody wanted to get your flowers. I think they're a bit gay. I wanted to get you a brushes voucher, but I looked through a brushes store. They're not there anymore. But I just want to say it's been such an honour to be share the 10 years with you and everybody. I mean, Australians just love you. Like, everywhere we go, we get asked, and it's a real honour to say that we work with you, and you couldn't have... still wrapping my head around it. We spoke about this, you know, I've had a few weeks to get my head around it, and I'm still not quite, doesn't feel real, but we're obviously going to be mates for a long time, but it is sad the show's ending, and mate, we love you, and you know, we'll see you soon.
Thank you.
These are actually props, so I've got to take them back as
fair
well.
Enough,
so.
That's very nice. Well, thank you very much. Well... on that, let me say thank you to everybody who makes this show possible. I mean, you can see tonight alone, I mean, this is not an easy undertaking to put one of these together and to do it live, but we have a fantastic team that do it. And I would like to thank our crew that do that. Some of them have been here since day one. I would particularly like to thank our director, Peter Ott, our audio director, Sam Caserta, and our floor manager, Kath Foxy Fox, my lifeline, who without which I look out into the abyss and I panic. I don't know what's going on. I'm just a weird talking monkey. I'd like to thank Network 10, of course, for giving us the platform to make this happen. I would like to thank our team, our Roving Enterprises team. There's a whole bunch of them over the corner there. And some of these guys have... I've known some of them since I was at Channel 31. I would like to also make special mention of Craig Campbell, Rob Brearley, Amber Kane, Rachel Miller, Todd Abbott, without whom this show wouldn't have happened. Some of them even discovered me, found me, and took me from relative obscurity to... to semi-obscurity on Network 10, but we at least we're at a network, which was fun. And also I'd like to thank our very hard-working team that, especially the last couple of years since we've been on weekends, but we all got together yesterday for our last day in the office, as we do each and every week when we start putting the finishing touches to all our writing and scripts. We went out and we all had lunch together at the pub at the Road and we just laughed. And you don't get that very often in this industry. Just a wonderful team of people that you just adore working with, and I thank them each for their hard work and dedication over the last years. Thank you very much. And also to the families, I'm so sorry. It wasn't our idea to do weekends. And I thank them very much for their respect, their support, their tolerance. We took fathers away from wives, and I don't know why fathers married to one, you know, away from their kids, from their families, and I do apologise for that, but I'm very thankful that you gave us your very talented people to work with. And I'd like to thank my family, especially I'd like to thank my mum, I'd like to thank Belinda, I'd like to thank Tasma for their love and support, because I couldn't have done it without them. Thank you very much. And I would very much like to thank this group of people.
As good as a burnout.
That's it.
Can I just
that's
say...
it. His car broke down.
Dad, why do you do this, Dad? I'm so sorry.
But I'd like to thank this group of people here. It's been a thrill, a joy, and a pleasure to work with this talented group of individuals. And look, you know, this industry, it's so much fun. It's a joy to be part of, but it's not always a pleasant place, and it can turn saints into sinners. But these guys here, the longer we work together, the closer our friendship becomes. Pete Heller in particular, I've known this guy since I moved here some 15 years ago, and it's just been such a tight friendship. You're like family to me, and I love you all dearly, and thank you for allowing me to make this happen. Thank you very much. Because people get sick. If it's just you doing the same what the shit every week. You gotta bring new people in. I'm for the you can be guaranteed it's not coming back now. Surely we can put it to rest. And finally, I guess that leaves you guys. All of you in the audience here for coming out, all of you who watch at home, because without you switching on your sets for the last 10 years, this show would not have existed, and I wouldn't have had the chance to live a dream. This is all I've ever wanted to do, and as I said at the start of the show, to be walking away from it, it's really hard to do, and it's not a decision that I have taken lightly, but it just feels like the right thing to do, and I hope you will understand. I would like to think we'll see each other again at some point in the future, but until then, from the bottom of my heart and with a tear in my eye, I say thank you, thank you, thank you. And thank you. I should point out, there is a warm-up guy, and I'd like to acknowledge him, actually. Kynan Barker, TV's KB, has been with us. I've known him longer than, I've even been doing this show, and he's been with us since day one as well, and I'd like to give him a big round of applause because he makes them do this. He makes them do this. So for the last time, thank you very much for allowing me into your home, not in a creepy way. I have been sneaking in and perving on you when you're asleep. But through the power of television, I say thank you very much. I'm Rove McManus. Say bye to your mum for me. Welcome to our sophisticated show.
What happened to you called Keith?
That doesn't work. We'll be back with more of Keith after this.
Oh, God! Have you ever been to an orgy?
Yeah.
The JJ.
Sex shop.
Is this Rove? Rove's different for 2009.
We turn it up, baby. Get ready for it. I wanna touch you. You wanna touch me too. Oh.
Lucky I put my money on the storm.
I'm a bikini lover. Yes.
Listen, you little punk. Let me finish.
Man, that's good shit.
Whose idea was this? Not mine.
I fight like a girl.
No, whoa, whoa!
Edit.
Softer,
emails I've sent you that you don't return.
Well, yeah, but techno. I don't like you. What?
That was weird.
Are you suggesting I should wear more?
No, not at all.
Definitely not. We just made that clear.
You bastard.
Creepy uncle. Right there.
What was your nickname in school? Embarrassing, but Captain Awesome.
How many times a day do you actually shake the sauce bottle?
Not often enough.
Is that it?
That's it.
Oh, I was enjoying that.